English pronunciation is hard, and that is because sometimes consonants are just too difficult to pronounce in a word in English. We see a word written on paper, but we do not pronounce every single letter as it is written. These are called silent letters, and that is the topic we are going to look at today. I'm Hannah, an English teacher at Virtually Fluent, and today we are going to go through the alphabet from A all the way through to Z to find out how some letters are silent in English, why we don't pronounce them. You can put this into practice and complete many of our pronunciation activities by accessing our silent letters course. You can find the link to this in the description below. So let's get started with the letter A. Now, A is not normally pronounced when it comes immediately before LLY, which will most likely be at the end of a word. For example, basically, critically, physically. You cannot hear that A sound in these words. Moving on to the letter B, one of my favourites. So when the final two letters of the word are MB, we do not pronounce this B. Lamb, thumb, comb, no B. It's really important that this is at the end of the word though, because if it's in the middle, like remember or embarrass, we do hear that B. Just be careful because some words only have additional suffixes. Let's take the example of plumber. This also has a silent B, only because that ER is an additional suffix. The root word is plum, plumber. And when we see the letters BT together, they are also silent. Debt, doubt, subtle. Moving on to the letter C, and this is silent when it's next to an S. For example, muscle, scissors, science. We don't want to hear that k sound, we only want that s instead. I also want to point out what I call a merged sound. When we have two letters next to each other, we don't pronounce both of those letters. This is particularly important when C is next to a K or a Q because they both have the same sound. For example, acquire, not acquire, acquire, or block. We only pronounce one of those K sounds. There are also some other situations where a C might not be sounded as Now, I call this a completely different change of sound. When we have a C and an H next to each other, sometimes, not 100% of the time, but sometimes they come together to create a new sound, which in this case is ch. For example, church or witch. We can't hear that k sound because it has converted into a ch. And there's sometimes just random words that do not follow the rules. For example, yacht. No C, no H, both silent, just yacht. Moving on to the letter D, and this is when we have an N next to the D. For example, handsome, handsome, handkerchief, handkerchief, sandwich, sandwich. There's no D in any of these words. Similar to our ch example, when we see a D next to a G, again, they often come together and create a completely new sound. In this case, a j sound. For example, fudge or bridge. We don't hear a d sound in these words. And again, a random word, Wednesday, Wednesday. Now we are moving on to the letter E. And this is mostly silent when it is the last letter in the word. This is what we are taught here in the UK as the magic E, because when we have an E at the end of a word, it normally elongates any vowel before. In general, we do not pronounce this when it is the last letter in a word. For example, love, hate, face. And also words ending in ed do not have an e sound in them. I do recommend learning the correct pronunciation of these words because words ending in ed follow a very specific rule. We do have another video and course on that. A few examples are kissed, watched, and cleaned. Now we're moving on to the letter G, and this is silent in quite a few situations. The G is silent when it is next to an N, either at the beginning or the end of a word. For example, foreign, sign, gnome. If the GN is in the middle of the word, it is not normally silent. You can hear it. For example, magnet, signature, cognitive. The only exceptions to this are words that are typically French or not traditionally from the English language. For example, champagne or cologne. When we see the letters G and H together, these are also silent. For example, high, light, daughter. But this GH sound is actually quite complicated because sometimes it is not silent, sometimes it completely changes the sound. And the examples I want to look at here are with the F sound. For example, laugh, cough, enough. We have completely changed this sound. It's not a G, it's not an H, no silent letters. Just a completely new sound. But if we continue with this example of GH, sometimes we do pronounce the G, but the H is silent. For example, ghost or gherkin. So when you see these letters GH next to each other in English, sometimes the G is silent, sometimes it's a F sound, and sometimes the H is silent. There are quite a few situations where the H is also silent. For example, CH, such as chemistry, Christmas, echo, or when we have RH next to each other, rhythm, rhino. Also a WH, when, where, what. But be careful because sometimes we do pronounce the H sound when we see WH next to each other. Typically, this is when the next letter afterwards is an O. For example, who or whole. Most words that start with the letter H do pronounce the H. It is not silent. There are a few words though, for example, hour, honest, and air, where the H is silent. Let's move on to the letter K, and this is only silent when the first letters are K and N. For example, no, knife, or knee. L is silent when it is in the middle and immediately before it is an A, an O, or a U. For example, salmon. Not salmon, I've heard this many a time, salmon. Also yolk, which is the yellow part of an egg, yolk. And should. However, when we have AL, OL, or UL at the beginning of a word or right at the end of a word, it is pronounced. For example, metal, old, ultimate. And there are also some words that are in the middle, A-L, O-L, U-L. They simply don't follow the rule. Sold, bulk, halo. Moving on to the letter M, and these are very strange words that do not pronounce the letter M. Nobody really uses these on a daily basis, but it is when the first two letters are M, N. For example, mnemonic. We pronounce the N instead. So now we're moving on to N, and this is always silent when the last two letters are M, N. For example, autumn, column, hymn. P is silent when the first two letters of a word are PS, PN, or PT. Most English teachers will use the same example words for this rule because there aren't many words that follow this rule. For example, psychology, pneumonia, and pterodactyl. But if we have PS, PN, or PT in the middle of a word or at the end of a word, it will be pronounced. For example, cups, hypnotherapy, helicopter. Two random words that have a silent P are receipt, no P, receipt, and also a coup. I also want to point out that sometimes a P can change its sound. When it is next to an H, it often converts to F instead. For example, phone and pheasant. Okay, we're up to the letter S. Now, these are completely random words that have a silent S, no particular rule. Any formation of these words here will also have the silent S. For example, aisle, island, and debris. Okay, we're up to the letter T. Generally, words ending in S-T-L-E will have a silent T. For example, castle, thistle, and whistle. Also an S-T-E-N ending. For example, listen, moisten, fasten. In English, we steal a lot of words from other languages, and we try to maintain the pronunciation of these words, unless, of course, that particular sound doesn't exist in English. We have a lot of words from the French language in English, and a lot of French words do end in T. When we have brought them into English, we don't want to pronounce the T. For example, ballet, beret, rapport. But there are some random words too that also have a silent T. Most commonly, asthma, Christmas, mortgage, and often. Okay, we are up to the letter U, and this is not normally pronounced when it is with a G, G-U, and followed by a vowel immediately after. For example, guitar, guard, guide. It doesn't always have to be at the beginning of a word, it could be at the end. A common combination of letters you might see is G-U-E at the end of a word. For example, tongue, catalogue, fatigue. And we have some random words too. For example, biscuit, circuit, and build. Now to the letter W. So, when we have a WR at the beginning of a word, it is most likely a silent W, and it's pronounced as R instead, that R. For example, right, wrong, and wrist. You might remember from earlier in this video, we looked at some WH words. We were looking at the silent H. Actually, with WH words followed by an O, the W is silent, and it's that H that we can hear instead. For example, who and whole. And of course, a few random words to answer, sword, and two. There are only two letters left in the alphabet that can be silent. The first one is X, and this is not a particularly common letter in English, especially when it is silent. I can only think of one example, and this has been taken from the French language. This is faux. And with the letter Z, it's exactly the same, a rendezvous. For some reason, we like to keep that French pronunciation and incorporate that French word into English too. To download all the slides used in our presentation, as well as access a whole list of other words with silent letters, you can easily head over to our silent letters course. The link to this course is in the description below. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and turn notifications on to see lots more videos just like this with other pronunciation, but also vocabulary and grammar explanations. And we have videos that use English in everyday life and situations. This is Hannah from Virtually Fluent, bringing English to life.